What is going on, YouTube? It is your boy, DaRon. You guys already know today's video is gonna be fire. As we're gonna talk about things that I wish I knew in my early 20s, man. It's crazy now, I'm 25 now, and I know a lot of you guys watching this video will probably relate to me, or I know a lot of you guys are praying a better position, which is fine, you know what I'm saying? It's fine. I'm 25 now, and when I think about my past, when I think about like my early 20s, especially like around 19, 20, 21, 22, 20, from 19 all the way to 24, when I think about the things that I wish I would have changed, like when you guys have mentors, I think it's very important to listen to your mentor, especially your parents. And you know what I'm saying, like I didn't have like a physical mentor, but like my mom, you know what I mean, like for people that's out there that grew up with a single mom, y'all know how they play, man. They play the daddy role and the mommy role. They play every role. They play the doctor, they play everything you can think about, you can think of in a book, your dad single person will play it. Shout out to the dads out there that's also single dad as well, raising their kids. You feel me? Like those people, they play both roles, man. It's crazy when you see them play both roles and you still don't listen to what they're telling you. And that's how I feel. I feel like, you know what I mean? Like I was set up for success at an early age, but I'm the one that was the problem. In my 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. All right, let me just say from 19 to 24, I just, you know, when you come from poverty, when you come from places where you have always been in, you've never been exposed to other things in life, and that's how I felt around those ages. I just felt like as I was getting older, I was never really introduced to a lot of things in life, but I never knew that my mom was doing it just to protect me, to not be able to fall in the future, to not be able to be in the situation that I've had put myself in. So when I was 19, you know, I always wanted to party. And you guys know everybody that's 19 want to party. Y'all know you're young-minded. You are like an adult at 19, because once you're 18, you're an adult now. Consider yourself an adult. I don't care if y'all wait till 21. Nah, 18, you're an adult. So, you know, the way I was thinking was just not it. I felt like I was thinking better when I was younger versus when I was getting older. As you get older, your mindset is just on the things that you that. You know what I mean? It's all about just fun, about partying, all that stuff. And it's funny because I remember when I had gotten a job, I was making like good money, and my mom was like, "Hey, DaRon, look, you're 18 right now. If you start investing your money, by the time you're like 40, whatever, like you're gonna be good, you're gonna be set." They were not like the best investment, but it made sense. You know what I mean? Like it made sense. I remember she told me when I was 18, "Hey, I need you to open a 401k account at the age of 18." I'm like, I'm only 18. I'm not worrying about retirement at 18. You know, things like that. But it made sense. As you get older, it started to make sense. Like, damn, I wish I would have started that when I was younger. I'm still young. I mean, 25. I still got a lot of time to go. But this is just things that I wish somebody would have. I wish I would have, like, really took it serious. So that's one of the things. Just investing in my future. I felt like investing in my future, I wish I would have took it more serious. It could be school. It could be business. Whatever it was, I felt like I spent all my money in just like the fun, taking women out to eat. I was like, I don't know, I felt like I was like a player when I was young, man. Like every couple of months I had like a different woman I was taking out to eat. Well, I wasn't really in relationships, none of that stuff, because at the end of the day, I knew for sure that those women, I ain't really like, I don't see myself with them in the next 5-10 years. It was just for the hype of it. Like, you know, when you make money, you just like you around the most beautiful woman. That's how I felt. Like I'm making good bread and I was around the most beautiful women, man. It's just like, man, like, and my friends are looking like, "Yo, DaRon, this shoe?" I'm like, "Yeah." But I knew that wasn't me. I knew deep down that beauty, man, wasn't like, it was just beauty. It was just all for the fun of it. It was all just for the hype. Because you know, when you get a certain status, all right, you always got that peer pressure where your friend is like, "Hey, I bet you want Garrett. Or I bet you," you know what I'm saying? And it was just that. And we used to always do that. And I used to always get them. Because as they see what you, as soon as they would see what you got and what you made and stuff like that, man, they would get on you like glue. Like, man, I was like, yaga. So, and those are the things, man. Those are the things that I wish that I would have changed. You know, if I can go back in time. But we all know we can't go back in time, and you don't want to live a life of regret. The only thing is that you can do is better yourself today. But yeah, so another thing is, I remember when I was, working in a restaurant, I got promoted very early. I got promoted like 20, you know, I was like a general manager at 20 years old, making, over 50K at 20, you know what I mean? I think I was making close to 60, something like that. at 20, and I'm still living with my parents, so you know, I'm not paying like all the bills and stuff like that, which is pretty generous. If you live with your parents and like if they don't make you pay a lot of bills, man, you got to be very thankful, because you know when them bills get heavy, man, it gets really heavy. But one thing that I wish I would have took advantage is like when I was getting paid, and really like just start saving, start investing, actually going back to school, because when I turned 20, when I got promoted to general manager, I had to put school on the side. I felt like school was not really for me anymore because I was already making good money. You know, there's people that get degrees and don't even make $40,000. You know what I mean? And I just felt like everybody that I was actually leading, everybody that I was managing, most of them had degrees and they were working for me. It just made no sense. At 20, you like they were like 30, 29, 40 working for me. And I was just like, man, I don't want to waste my time going to school, get this degree, blah, blah, blah. And all those were just like false ideas playing in my mind, because I felt content. I felt comfortable. And that's one bad thing, you know, if you're young, if you're still in your 20 right now, if you're still in your early 20s right now, or 19, one thing I can tell you right now is do not feel comfortable in life. Don't feel comfortable. You want to be, now, when I say feel, you want to be uncomfortable, it doesn't mean feel weird. No, but you just don't want to settle. Don't settle for things that you know are not going to benefit you, all right? The party, the lifestyle, the women, all that stuff, it's okay. Not gonna say it's good, because there's not always a perfect ending to that stuff. It's always good in the moment, but then later on it's bad. It catches up to you real bad, especially if you're a guy that's out there just living the life of your dream with women. Bro, you're gonna have like 10 kids like in the next couple of years, I'm trying to tell you. I have no kids though, thank God, bro, thank God. But you know, those are just those things that when you're in your 20s, it's very important to listen to your parents. I feel like our parents have, they've been there before. They've seen the lifestyle that we've lived, especially me coming from like a Christian home. You know, it was kind of like embarrassing me coming from a Christian home and showing the type of habits that I was showing to my mom and to the family. It kind of felt like I was not even raised in that house. It felt like the outside had kind of changed me a little bit, especially when you go to school and you're around friends that are bad examples. But because you know those friends are lit, you know those people are lit. Those friends are always like, you know, they bring the party to life. They bring the life to the life to the party. Those friends are there for you to never be bored. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was missing that, okay, because I didn't grow up around that. So because of that hype, you know, I felt more fulfilled now. Like, I felt a little bit like of happiness around them. But that happiness, it was not real happiness. It was just excitement, really, for the soul. But it was not happiness for the spirit. It was just for the soul. I mean, like, whatever my soul desired, whatever I wanted at the moment, whatever I wanted at the time, my soul was like, yes. But my spirit deep down was telling me, like, this is not where you belong. This is not the right thing for you to do. My spirit was always talking to me, like, listen to your mom, listen to your parents, listen to the people teaching you how to be a better person, how to be a better adult. All right, so if you're really, like I say, if you're out there, you're young, and you're in a situation where you're not, you feel like you are like lost, if you feel like you are not where you wanted to be, like when you look at some years back, I know you had like visions, you had projects, you had like some dreams of becoming bigger things than you are today. I'm gonna let you know right now, it is not too late. The best thing that you can do right now is like restart. You want to hit a restart button, and you really want to watch your friends, man. Watch the people around you, listen to your parents. I know a lot of us, some of you guys, I know you don't have the best parents, but listen to those people that are giving you the best advice that's going to benefit you as an adult. The advice that's going to help you tomorrow. Today it might be hard for you to really live up to those advices, but bruh, in the future, tomorrow, I'm trying to tell you, those advices are going to be the best thing that could possibly happen in your life. They're going to help you financially, physically, emotionally, spiritually. Those advices that your parents, your mom, your dad give you are going to help you. Even if it's to go to school and finish school, whatever it is, just listen. Like, for once, you know, once in my life, I was just like, why do I always have to fight back the things that are good for me? I know sometimes we want things of our own. I know sometimes we want to discover our own future, which is good. You should always discover things on your own. But you never want to neglect. Don't neglect the things that are the advices that are being given to you by the people that have lived where you've been before, okay? So those people see danger from a mile away. You don't. You have never been there. And I know a lot of us are people that always like to get in some type of situation in order for us to learn. But sometimes it doesn't have to be like that. When you know for sure that you're gonna get in a bad situation, avoid that. Okay, you already know what could possibly happen. You don't have to physically feel that. You already know what could possibly happen. So just avoid that, okay? Avoid that, guys. Like, you guys listen to this. Please, all right? It's time for you guys to turn and change things around. Watch your surrounding. Watch the five people around you right now. All right, guys, you want to watch those people. You're going to be the average of those people around you. And I became the average of the five people around me. I'm not anymore because I've changed my circle. I barely have any friends, y'all. I barely hang around anybody. I'm like a homebody now. I do everything on my own, business-wise, my videos, everything that I do to really put me at peace, I do it on my own. So I don't know, man. I just feel like the friends I had, the people I used to hang out with, those people would bring me, they would not lead me in the right direction. I felt like I was getting a little bit influenced. I should have been the one influencing them, but it wasn't influencing me. So, you know, you can't hang around somebody that steals every day, or you can't hang around a group of people that like to steal, and you're not gonna steal, like, at least one time. Like, it's gonna happen, bro. Peer pressure is real. You're gonna hang around those people for 5 years, one time they're gonna push you to steal, or else, you feel me, or else. So it's gonna happen. Those people are gonna influence you in the way they talk, the way they walk, the way they act, the way they react. They're gonna influence you. So you wanna really, if you wanna move forward in life, man, it's really important to watch your circle. You wanna be careful on what type of energy you bring towards you, because certain energy is just not good for the soul, it's not good for the mind, it's not good for the spirit. So you wanna watch out for that. You want to bring the right type of energy, the energy that's going to uplift you, that's going to put you in a better state of mind, a better position that you were yesterday. That's the type of energy I love to be around. So for me, I am an entrepreneur. So whenever I'm like working on something, I like to be around entrepreneurs. I like to feel how they feel and see and think how they think. You know what I'm saying? Because entrepreneurs, we are problem solvers. We are like engineers. We solve problems and we sell solutions to the people. Alright, engineers, yes, they solve problems, but we solve problems and sell those problems. And we solve problems and sell those solutions to the people. And I like to think like that. I like to be around people that think that way. And I mean, I had to remove myself away from people that always think short term, you know, like YOLO, live wild now because tomorrow is never promised. We know tomorrow is not promised, but it's always best to be prepared for tomorrow. Alright. If you have this mindset where you have to live wild today and waste, spend all your money today because tomorrow is not promised. But what if you make it to 80 years? What if, right? Will you prepare for it? Come on, bro. It just makes no sense. There's no real logic to people that always say you want to live wild today. Live crazy right now. Enjoy your life to the fullest right now. And tomorrow we take care of yourself. It is true. It's even written in the Bible that, you know what I mean? Like, tomorrow will take care of itself. Only God knows tomorrow. You don't know tomorrow. But it's also written that it's best to be prepared. It's best to get ready. It's best to see danger ahead and get and run away from that. It's best to know that tomorrow you're going to be a dad and get ready today for your kids tomorrow. It's always best to be prepared, even though you don't know what the future holds. All right. And that's one thing I wish I would have done in the early age, like in my 17, even when I was in high school. I wish, because I used to sell candy in high school, snacks. I spent all my money in like shoes and clothes, all that stuff. I don't have those stuff today anymore because those things are liabilities. They are not assets. I wish I would have spent my time and really investing in assets since the age of 17 or 18. But you know, I don't regret the things that I've done, but I do regret sometimes not listening to my mom and for the advice she gave me. But you know what I'm saying? But I feel like that was a learning experience for me. So I know when I have kids in the future, you know what I mean? Like, the things that I know I did, I'm trying to tell you. Boy, if they won't try and be all tough up like I was tough up, it's gonna be a problem, a real problem. All right, that's why it's very important to teach them when they're young about all these things, so as they get older, they learn. And I feel like my mom has been doing it, and I have been learning when I was younger. But as I got older and really went into the wrong crowd, that's when everything I learned kind of like poof, disappeared. I became like a walking zombie, somebody that was just walking with a group and not knowing where the heck is going. That's how I felt. But today I'm glad I found my way back. I know exactly what I want to do. I know exactly what I'm doing. I know exactly who I want to be around. As you guys know, I'm single for a reason, because I also feel like I haven't been around the right energy, as far as, you know, women wise as well. I have not been around the right energy. So for there, because of that, I always remove myself away from that. So that way I know I can work on myself a bit more. I want to sharpen myself like a sword. You feel me? So when it's time to attack, I am sharp and ready to go to battle. But again, I appreciate y'all making fun of this video, man. If you guys feel down, y'all feel like y'all have not accomplished things that y'all really want to accomplish, do not feel bad. Don't feel sad. Just know that it's time for you to restart a new journey, a better journey, a faster journey. Because you've learned from all these. If you have not learned from all the mistakes you made, then you're just living a plain life. That's very dangerous. When you live a plain life, it's dangerous because you don't know where you're going. You feel lost. You feel really lost. So it's time for you today to take action and not repeating the same mistakes that you made, and listening to the people really giving you the right advices that's gonna help you flourish and grow in life. Appreciate y'all for listening, man. Appreciate y'all for tuning in on this video. I hope you guys subscribe to my channel so I can keep making more videos like this again. Alright guys, I'm gonna be dropping 2 videos a week, so be on the watch out for that. Make sure you subscribe to my channel, turn on the notification. Alright, if you guys have not followed me on social media, make sure you guys follow me on social media as well at @itsDeron_. Appreciate y'all. Love y'all, man. I'm out. You heard me. Woo!